Stop screwing with me here. All right, everyone. Welcome back to Knickknacks Presents Mass Effect 2, part of our continued run through of the Mass Effect series. So, this might end up being a short episode. I have something I'm supposed to be. That I would help out a friend with something. I'm still waiting to hear back from them on what the time frame of it is. So if this is a short episode, that would be why. Also, I mean, the last episode I gave you guys was like 2 hours change. So I think it's only fair. So first, that back in. I don't think that we scarred the codex entry for the planet the Shadow Broker ship was on. I think it just took us right to the ship, so. Though Haugalas has a nitrogen-oxygen atmosphere capable of supporting life, its rotational period is slower than Earth's, making its day and night 98 Earth days long. The intense heat on one side of the planet and the violent extreme cold on the other make for violent storm cells whenever the sun is rising or setting. As a result, the flora and fauna of Haugalas have developed the capacity to live in cycles of ice, flooding, baking heat, and dynamic air pressure changes. The biota of the planets has been largely unexploited by exotic pet and gardening trades, simulating their natural conditions is problematic for the average consumer. So we're going to go ahead and get back onto the Shadow Broker base, because there are those resources and the terminal missions stuff you can do that refreshes. Every day. The investment opportunities board over here. Warning signal. Success! Admiral Hacken and the 5th Fleet have ambushed the colony raiding pirates. Plus 2,000 credits. Bureaucracy in action. Mission report Letty. Failure. Soda Foundation's antibiotic tests have been blocked by Citadel legislation. I didn't even really realize you could fail these missions. Smear campaign. Mission report ready. Success! The politician retires from public service after your smear campaign. Plus 5,000 credits. Just reward. Mission report ready. Success! The police quietly slip you a cut from their raid on the Red Sand Factory. Plus 3,000 credits. Embedded correspondence. Citadel news agencies are trying to place more reporters in the Terminus systems. Use your resources to set up these journalists with safe houses and reliable contacts so they can bring back news from the galaxy's frontier. Yeah, that sounds good. Blue listed. Blue Suns are becoming dangerously powerful. Run a galaxy-wide expose on their corruption and tendency to turn on their employers. It will send business to their competitors. Sure, why not? Mutually assured income. Clashes between countries on the Batarian homeworld of Karshan are becoming frequent. Make sure no nation-state gains more control than the others by regulating weapon sales to all sides. Sure. Chemical warfare. Binary Helix is trying to develop hormone implants for Alliance soldiers that fall outside the Citadel's generic treaty laws. The company is prepared to be very generous if you let them know when the Citadel inspectors are coming. Sure. So, all of those done. Here. SMG technology. Batarian State Arms has sent a schematic for modifying the SMG in exchange for help in blackmailing Citadel officials. And plus 2,500 platinum. Okay.
As you requested, I have acquired the soul. religion.
Submachine gun damage, 6 out of 6. Absolutely. Even though I find myself using sniper rifles more and more. Definitely more than I realized. Even when I played soldier, I never really used snipers all that much. Now, ever since I got my specialization unlocked, I've been using them a lot in this run through. Alright, let's get out of here. Yep. I just want to say, I really do like this game. I wish the main story plot was anywhere close to as good as all the recruitment missions and loyalty missions and all of the other side stuff that goes on in it, because those are much better than what actually happens with the collectors in the main story.
His psych profile mentioned little of it, and he carries himself with such cold confidence. I'm not sure if I find him scary or sexy.
A lot of women like bad boys.
That is a dirty stereotype. In my case, it happens to be true, but still. Anyway, what's up?
Is there anything I should know?
Tally seems very distraught after receiving a message. Maybe you could check in on her down in engineering. Anything else, Commander?
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Alright, so we're gonna do our normal run through of the Normandy. After all, we did just get done with the Shadow Broker mission.
Commander.
I assume everything is going well up here?
Good for now. Fractured my thumb on the mute, but
that's
I think
it for now.
See you, Commander.
A normal run through of the Normandy, check up with everyone. And then we're gonna start cracking on more of these loyalty missions. Probably going back to the Citadel and getting Thane and Garrus and Kasumi. Obviously not all of those today. So I'm still missing one of the ship models. You can see I got the Shadow Broker model there now. This is the DLC. I really, really hate that I have Ashley's picture up there, because I tried very hard not to romance her in the first game, and yet it still says that we had a romance. It's very upsetting.
I hope we can go to Omega soon.
I'll think about that. Meanwhile, I have to go.
Of course.
I wish you had other things you could talk to with your squad mates about, even while not going on their loyalty missions. Because If you want to make sure you get all the dialogue and stuff, you have to do a lot of laps of the ship while you still have loyalty missions waiting for you. And go and talk to them, and all just like, I hope we could go take care of my issues soon.
Have you visited the Citadel yet?
Not yet.
I shall return to my meditations.
There you are. Joker and Edie are like an old married couple. I keep expecting to walk in on them bickering about the temperature in the cockpit. Edie has a wicked sense of humor. Or I should say, a really funny one.
Meanwhile, Kasumi and Zaid at this point are just cycling back on dialogue they've already said. I do think this, like a lot of other things,
Commander.
3 is better in that there's lots of just dynamic conversations you can walk in on and...
Maybe another time.
I'll let you work.
Of course, Commander.
I wish they didn't use that for you gathering your side missions as much as they do, but I do like the dynamic conversations going on between your squad mates and that kind of stuff, which you get a lot of in 3.
Any chance we could get to the Citadel, Shepard? I'd like to follow that lead on Sidonis.
Yeah. You know, calm down.
I'll be here if you need me.
Yeah, just talk to your bro. You have to be so focused on putting a bullet in Sidonis.
Done to your power grid balance?
Not much. With built-in capacitor subsystems, they have a surprisingly low draw.
Doesn't that mean the shielding boost wouldn't last long under fire?
True. They're built for hard, fast strikes, not firefights of attrition.
Shepard, I'm glad you came by. I may need your help. I just received a message from the migrant fleet. The Admiralty Ward has accused me of treason. I'm scared, Shepard.
Nobody who knows you could believe you'd betray your people, Tally.
I don't know. They don't lay charges like this unless the evidence seems absolute. But thanks. I appreciate your faith in me, Shepard.
Is it because you're working with Cerberus?
I'm not working with Cerberus. I'm working with you. And I got leave to serve on the Normandy again. I have no idea what they're accusing me of. You'd think I would remember if I betrayed the fleet.
What happens when the Quarian is accused of treason?
There's a hearing with members of the Admiralty Board acting as judges. My father is an admiral on the board. He'll have to recuse himself from judgment. I can't even imagine what he's thinking right now. The punishment for treason is exile. If they convict me, I can never go back.
So you have no idea why they're accusing you?
None. The specifics of charges like this are rarely discussed on open channels. I won't know any more until I get to the flotilla.
What happens if you're convicted?
Like I said, exile. The specifics are up to the judges. If it's deemed only a tragic mistake in judgment, the guilty party might receive a small ship and supplies. Not that it really matters. Either way, if I'm convicted, I'll never see the migrant fleet again.
So no prison and no death penalty?
We don't have the spare resources for long-term incarceration. Monitored work detail is more effective. And we don't have enough people to afford execution. An exile can still have children, and those children are welcomed back to the fleet.
How often is someone from the fleet charged with treason?
It's rare. It must be something that affects the entire flotilla, not just one ship. The most recent one was Onora Vanya Vasilani, an engineer who handed over fleet defense schematics to the Batarians.
She had good intentions. The Batarians were contracted to upgrade our systems, but they passed as defense schematics to a pirate gang.
Was she convicted?
No. She made a suicide run on the pirate gang. She destroyed them before they could attack the fleet. She was pardoned, posthumously. Let's hope I don't have to prove my innocence that way.
Okay, let's go find those little
As if any pirate gang could take down Tali Zora Vasnima.
I didn't think there would be time for you to help. Thank you, Shepard. I'll program the Normandy with the flotilla's current location. The admirals will be waiting for us.
Alright, so that is everyone's loyalty mission now unlocked. And that we have a Codex entry. Migrant fleet. The flotilla, or the migrant fleet, is a fleet of roughly 50,000 starships that houses over 17 million Quarians. The largest collection of starfaring vessels in the galaxy. The fleet is so large it may take days for all the ships to pass through a mass fleet relay. Ships are constantly repaired, replaced, and upgraded to comfortably house as many Quarians as possible. Typically, the ships specialize in roles for the fleet, from the enormous agricultural live ships to the shielded lab ships and repurposed freighters known as home ships that house Quarian children, young parents, and educators. Employed Quarians typically live in the ship they work on, since commuting from ship to ship ties up resources with unnecessary docking procedures. Even within the flotilla, Quarians on most ships will remain encased in their protective suits. Rarely, Quarians will meet on clean ships for specific purposes such as medical services or reproduction. When this occurs, they remove their suits, knowing full well that it is likely they will spend a few days having allergic reactions or getting over infections as their weakened immune systems compensate for each other's presence. And a codex entry from the Shadow Broker DLC of the Yogg, which is the species that the Shadow Broker ended up being. The Yogg are a race of massive apex predators from the world of Parnak, whose rise to sentience in no way blunted their violent nature. A group of Yogg is unable to cooperate until a single leader has been determined, either through social maneuvering or brute force, but no grudges are held once a Yogg establishes dominance. Former rivals serve their new superior's purpose with unflinching loyalty and relentless determination, a legacy to their origin as pack species. Their eight eyes are another sign of their hunter ancestry. All four pairs are geared toward tracking down and predicting the movements of prey. Sophisticated and keenly developed sensitivity to movement and light have made Yogg masters at reading body language, regardless of species. Much to their short-lived chagrin, the Council's first contact teams discovered it was nearly impossible to lie to the Yogg. The Yogg had technology equivalent to 20th century Earth standards when they were discovered by the Council in 2125. The Council's ambassadors approached the Yogg as friends and allies instead of subordinates, a baffling sign of contempt from the newcomers on Parnak. The Yogg attacked when it became apparent that the alien diplomats stubbornly considered themselves sovereign people instead of new underlings. Parnak remains off-limit by order of the Council, which fears that the Yogg's size, aggression, and obsession with control make them poorly suited for integration into the galactic community. Yep, I am willing to bet that that is true. Okay, I'll put another 3 into warp ammo. Oh yeah, we got Tali's new mission. Okay. I actually don't have this, again, because the game just brought us here as part of the storyline. We haven't explored any of this new galaxy. We'll see if there's any interesting stuff in this cluster. Ah. A large rock planet, Answers, was once under development by a consortium of robo-mining interests, but an epidemic of accidents and sabotage cost the lives of hundreds of workers and eventually drove them off-world. Despite numerous accusations among the mining companies and a dozen or more trials, popular opinion holds that the real saboteurs were never found. Now, I wonder if you're supposed to assume that real saboteur was the Shadow Broker, keeping anyone from operating too close to the Shadow Broker's base of operations here. Okay, I guess it was only that system that we didn't have explored at all. The other two here in the rest of the Hourglass Nebula. Oh, no, this isn't the... system, it's... yeah, Osun down here. It has the mass relay. So that was a little bit of a detour. Alright, now, to the Citadel. So we've got Thane and Garrus's, and then Kasumi's loyalty mission is just off in the other system in this cluster. Now, we haven't been on the Citadel in a while. Since we are going for Thane's mission, we'll take him. And then Jacob, it's an interesting combination. Okay. Jacob, where are you? I'm on. Went into incendiary ammo. I'll give incendiary the squad. Because it is actually very useful. Not as useful as warp, but I don't have anyone with warp ammo right now, but that's a very useful squad power. And give him the specialist. I always generally default to doing more damage over being tankier, because you generally take damage pretty quickly in this game, unless you're specifically tank. Put them on the Eviscerator. Yeah, the Phalanx. Thane should be... yeah. Okay.
I've found references to a forger named Fade in CSEC crime reports, Shepard. Perhaps that is as good as I start looking. Also, according to CSEC, a drill recently passed customs. The CSEC office may have more information.
Okay, so I like Thane's mission more than...
An independent inquiry is investigating a group known as Cerberus in light of charges made by one Corporal Tombs and testimony...
I like Thane's loyalty mission more than Garrus's. So we're gonna go through and do that first.
I see no fewer than 14 fatal flaws a skilled assassin could exploit. 8 of them existed when I was here 10 years ago.
That is kind of funny that the additional security has actually made it easier as far as Thane's concerned.
My associate is trying to find his son. We think a local criminal may have hired him.
That should be easy. We don't see many drell here. There we go. One of my men reported to Drell recently. And he was talking to Mouse. Interesting.
Mouse?
Petty criminal. Probably not the guy who hired your boy, but a messenger. He's a former duct. Runs errands for anyone who'll pay.
What sort of trouble has Mouse been getting himself into?
Odd jobs for shifty people. Duct rats take whatever's available to get by. Data running, fencing stolen goods, selling illegal DI personalities. Actually, he was selling one of you.
Me?
Yeah, when you erased a file, it would say, I delete data like you on the way to real errors. Buggy, though, it crashed every half hour. The error message was about how the galaxy was at stake, and you should fix the problem yourself.
It's actually really funny.
What was it you called Mounts?
A duct rat. It's a local slang for the poor kids who grow up in the station. When they're small, they tend to play in the ventilation ducts where adults can't get to them.
Aren't the ducts dangerous?
Every couple of months, we pull a little body out of them. Lacerated by fan blades, broken by a deadfall, suffocated by vacuum exposure. Those are just the ones we know about. More just disappear. Maybe they get sucked into space. Maybe they fall into the protein vats the keepers run. The Mouse survived long enough that he can't fit in the ducts anymore. He was one of the smarter ones, or the luckier ones.
I've heard enough.
Mouse is usually upstairs outside the Dark Star. He works out of a public comm terminal. You should pick up a copy of the Shepard VI when you talk to him. It sounds like your boy's running with the wrong crowd.
Yes, I agree.
If Mouse can't get you in touch with your son directly, he'll know who can. I'll help you if you need it.
You don't know us, Captain. Why are you going so far to help us?
I've worked Sakara for 2 years. Every day kids turn to crime because they've got no other choice, because their parents don't care. You're trying to save yours.
He faces a dark path.
We better hurry then.
You didn't tell him that Kolyat plans to assassinate someone.
He's a cop. He tried to stop Kolyat, and one of them could end up dead. I don't want that.
Yes, of course. Thank you, Shepard.
Welcome to Citadel Newsnet. I'm Emily Wong. Horizon has become the latest and largest human-settled world to disappear in the wave of lost colonies. As before in such cases, the human representative to the Council has requested an official investigation. This was rejected by a 3-4 vote in session. The Council maintains the matter is an internal alliance issue. Counselor Ballard noted, having a seat on the Council implies a species can handle its own problems and assist others with theirs. Alliance Counselor Anderson agreed, but requested increased access to the Council's space tracking network.
Now, glad to see all those sacrifices we made were worth it. Hey, get some more fish. and the model of the Sovereign. That should be the last model I needed there. Oh, and it unlocks the codex entry for the Sovereign.
Amidst the flagship of the rogue Expector, Saren Arterius. Sovereign is a devastating dreadnought of unprecedented power. At 2 kilometers long, Sovereign was believed to have been powered by a gigantic Element Zero core, the only energy source potent enough to land the massive vessel on a planet. During the Eden Prime War, the ship unleashed its peerless destructive force against which Citadel Council ships were defenseless. With a virtually indestructible flagship and a crew of fanatic Geth and Krogan, Saren nearly succeeded in wiping out all his enemies. Only the resourcefulness and bravery of the commander and crew of the SSV Normandy stopped him. The overwhelming power of Sovereign ignited bizarre speculation in tabloid media that the vessel was sent by extragalactic invaders, or was, despite indeterminate photographic evidence at best, a single giant robot. Some sources even claimed that Sovereign was alive. Such conjecture, however baseless, remains to this day.
Yeah, conjecture remains because it's the truth. We'll let that get in the way of anything. I think the Dark Star is up there, so...
You think there's any place on board we could buy a fish?
I don't like live animals on the ship. Wasted life support capacity.
Nice.
The wreckage of the freighter Turalan was found on an uncolonized planet in the Dranic system. Salvage teams reported no survivors. The Systems Alliance Parliamentary Subcommittee for Transhuman Studies has awarded reparations for biotics suffering complications from L2 implants. Subcommittee Chairman Burns thanked biotics everywhere for their patience and understanding, and promised more help for those forgotten by the system until now. The Tyrian government is considering further reparations to humans whose ancestors died in the Relay 340.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the surface.
Yes, I will take additional tech damage.
So what's it?
I guess they haven't realized that the ship directly across from them here also has the same endorsement.
This is the warehouse where Garrus set up a meeting with the Forger. If you wish to find Fade, Garrus should accompany you.
Yeah, we'll take care of that later.
Now available on video, the abridged version of Francis.
Hiroshima!
Okay, back upstairs. I wish you didn't move so slowly. It doesn't let you sprint for very long before you get tired. Got a lot of armor on, but... One thing from Gears of War that I wish that they hadn't borrowed. In Gears, you can run a lot longer.
Operations on the Salon Hill system had been cleared. Operations had previously been halted after Geth activity in the area.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the Citadel.
Certa Foundation is likely to close by the end of this fiscal year. Centers 2 years ago.
The worst thing about extranet games is when some Batarian comes on and insists on speaking his own language without auto-translation.
Celebrations are planned across Terra Nova for the upcoming anniversary of the thwarted terrorist attack on the colony. Former hostage Kate Bowman is expected.
In everyone's life, there is a moment when things crystallize. You can see all the roads that have led you to that point, and all the paths that lie ahead. For you, Shepard, that moment may be when you first sit in the pilot seat of the Arlos 2185 Model 10.
Yeah, sure. I can get you 2 cases by the end of the day.
You mouse? Mouse?
What are you... Oh, shit. Krios. I thought you were tired. Commander Shepard. I thought you died. What do you want with me?
Be still, Mouse. You can change your pants in a moment.
How do you know
they don't think? If he didn't say nothing, I ain't either.
When we heard the name, I didn't think it could be the same Mouse. He was a contact on the Citadel when I was active. He and some other children would gather information on my targets.
You put children in danger to spy for you?
Children, the poor. My people's word for their kind is Dralafa, the ignored. They're everywhere, see everything. Yet they are never seen. You gave another Drell instructions for an assassination. Who's the target?
I don't know. I didn't ask. Because the people I work for, they can make me disappear. I'd like to help you, Krios. You've always done right by us, but I ain't gonna die for you.
Look, you know Thane. No. He wouldn't ask if it wasn't important. Do it for him.
I want to. He was always nice to us. But these people ain't nice, Krios.
Nobody's gonna know you talking to us.
Mouse, I swear that you won't be named.
All right. He came with that holler he took of me. Said he wanted a job. I ran through your old contacts to see who might give him a shot. The guy who offered was Elias Kellum.
One other thing. That Shepard VI you're selling?
Oh, shit. Look, you were dead. It was totally legal to make a VI of you.
Give me a copy, we'll call it even.
What? I mean, sure, yeah, absolutely. Sorry about the whole... Just so you know, there's 3 Volus who are patching it all the time.
Tell me about Kellum.
Human. Moved to the Citadel about 10 years ago. He was little people when you were here, Krios. He got big after the Geth attack. Lots of the big guys from before got cacked, all in them big fancy apartments up in the Presidium. Now he runs the rackets on the lower end of the ward. Shin Akiba. Seriously bad news.
You did good, Mouse.
Yeah. Hope I live long enough to pat myself on the back.
Kellum will never know.
I hope not. I'm out of here, Krios. Next time you're in town, just don't bring the family.
That couldn't have been easy.
Mouse knew more about my life than Kolyat ever did. He smiles up at me, broken teeth and scabby knees. Bare feet black. A dead-end future looking up at me, worshipping the petty gifts I offer. I was the only good thing he had back then. But I left him, as I left Kolyat.
Mouse said you had a hollow.
Yes. A foolish bit of sentimentality. I can perfectly recall every moment I spent with Mouse. He pulls at my arm, smiles. He wants to know that I'll remember him, that anyone will remember him.
I take the hollow. He smiles at himself in miniature on my palm. Then a frown crinkles his brow. He pats my pockets, checking for other hollows. Where's your son, Krios? He asks.
Don't blame yourself.
If I don't, who will? We must carry the weight of our decisions, Shepard. You, of all people, know this.
Let's head back to Bailey.
Yes?
Can we talk about my associate's son?
You talked to Mouse? Did you get the name of the guy he's working with?
Elias Kellum.
Kellum? Shit. Look, this is awkward. Kellum and I have an agreement. He doesn't cause too much trouble and buys tickets to the C-Sec charity ball from me in return. I ignore him.
He pays you off. You were eager to help us before. What about now? Is it too inconvenient?
I said I'd help. It's just there'll be no precautions if I don't handle it right. Brian and I give each other space. It keeps the peace. I'll get some of my people to bring him in and set him up in a private room. You can interrogate him yourself. I'll stay out of sight. And if I'm lucky, Kellum will believe that I had nothing to do with it.
I need to make some preparations. When I come back, we'll do this.
Fine. I'll come back before I lose my nerve.
I didn't realize that's how that was gonna go.
Yes?
Can we talk about my associates?
You ready to interrogate Kellum?
Bring him in.
Yep.
We might not have much time.
I'll make it happen. Wait here.
We've got Kellum. Tell Bailey we're ready.
He'll expect me to get him out of this.
Not today, I think.
Captain, his lawyer's here.
And Elias has his feet. I said to page him if C-Sec gets within 10 meters.
I'll stall him. Get in there and work fast.
We should question him. Keep the pressure on. Thoughts on how we approach it?
Convince him that we'll put a bullet in his head if he doesn't talk. Once he's scared, he'll cooperate.
Very well. I'll pretend we're ready to kill him. We can't push too hard, though. We need the information more than we need a corpse.
Get me out of these restraints, Bailey. Pretty funny bringing me down here like this. The hell are you two?
Bailey has nothing to do with this. We just want a few ads. Off the record.
Off the record in a C-Sec interrogation room? Sure.
You hired an assassin. Who do you want dead?
I
want
to see my advocate.
You apparently haven't noticed we're not C-Sec. No deals, no due process, no advocate.
And that's supposed to scare me. You two are in way over your heads. Bailey won't let you touch me.
Bailey doesn't know you're here, but he will, after we're done.
You're not the only one who can buy off C-Sec, Kellum.
What are you, Frame Boy? His little apologist? What, kid? You gonna bore me into confessing? You ain't shit. Come on, hit me. I dare you. No, didn't think you had the balls.
Think carefully, Elias. I want to catch the assassin, not you. Why stick your neck out for him?
You want me to confess to putting a contract on someone? You think I'm stupid?
I get the name, I walk out. You never see me again.
I got no reason to believe you.
Elias, if we were after you, we'd have already put a bullet in your head. can't stall his advocate for long.
Are we done here?
Done here.
Because I got PTSD. Goddamn waste of my time.
How about this?
About this.
You tell us the target.
I said get out of my way.
You have no right to.
No right to.
What the hell is going on here?
Going on it.
Step away from my car. Is that... Do you have him tied to the chair?
To the chair?
Glad you could make it, Freddy.
Traffic was bad. You'll need a shovel the size of the Citadel to dig yourself out of this.
This is all above board. I'm a council specter.
Shit.
What? What's that mean, Freddy?
Specters can do whatever they
want.
I can't help
it.
Shit.
If it was you I wanted, I could kill you and go. I want the assassin. Tell me who the target is, and I'll leave.
Damn it. Joram Talib. He's a Turian, running for intendant of the Hero War.
Where can we find him?
His apartment's in the 800 blocks.
Let's go.
Let's go.
What's the story?
What's the story?
Why'd Kellum hire the boy?
Assassination. Turian named Joram Talib. You know him?
Joram. Yeah. You might have seen his posters around. He's promising to end organized crime. Thing is, his message is all mixed up in race politics. He's anti-human.
Are things so bad that people can openly campaign as anti-human?
Before the Battle of the Citadel, the alien population thought we were violent upstarts. Look what's happened since then. A human fleet guarding the station for months? C-Sec filled with humans? Anderson does what he can, but some people have lived on the station since before humans had starships. They see it.
If a majority votes for it, like it or not, that's how the system works.
That's a nice ideal, Shepard. Sergeant, get a patrol car.
These
two need to get to the 800 blocks.
Yes, sir.
There he is. How do you want to play this?
Follow the lead on the maintenance catwalks. Tell me what he's doing. The Krogan bodyguard will make him easy to follow.
Where will you be?
The darkest corners with the best views. Amon Kira, Lord of Hunters. Grant that my hands be steady, my heading be true, and my feet swift. And should the words come to pass, grant me forgiveness.
Like I said, I really, really do enjoy this mission.
It's been wonderful talking with you all. I hope you'll come out on election day.
You can count on it.
Show the humans they won't get their way. Thanks. Just remember, it's not all about the humans. They couldn't have gained this much power without the council's support. Taking back off...
I'm on him, Thane. He's talking to some voters. You're in position?
Yes.
It's been wonderful talking with you all. I hope you'll come out on election day.
I'm following.
And after I was talking about how I like this mission so much. We are not... Crap.